illusion called success?
No. Success is not an illusion. Success is real. If success was not real, you people would not have been able to organize this program. The viewers would not be sitting and watching it. There is success in this world. It's not an illusion. Sometimes the illusion is within us as to what is success, and we chase the wrong rainbow. You've all heard of that old proverb which says, before you start climbing up the ladder of success, make sure that the ladder is kept against the correct wall. That is where all these illusions come in. That I start climbing, I'm in such a great hurry to start climbing and to see how much progress I'm making and how much nearer the end I am and stuff like that. That is what creates the illusion part of success. Okay, coming to success, I have a very, very different definition of success. It may not fit in with what a lot of people believe is success, but do give it a thought. And if you really give it a thought for sufficient amount of time, you will understand, at least to some extent, that what this man is saying makes at least a little bit of sense. Success, according to me, is peace within yourself and harmony with others. Full stop. Are you at peace within yourself, whatever you are doing? Or are you agitated? Are you confused? Are you questioning? Are you depressed? Are you regretting? Okay. Then there are a lot of people who are very much at peace within themselves because they make life miserable for others. So, equally important is peace within yourself and harmony with others. When I meet an old friend, does he put on a plastic smile and say, oh, this idiot has come again? Or does he say, hey Ali, I'm really glad to see you. Such a pleasure. When I say harmony with others, I'd also like to add a little rider. The significant others, the important others, the near and dear. Very easy for me to put on a good front outside, become very popular, and come back home and make life miserable for my family. So, if I have achieved, or if I am close to achieving, or if I am on that path, which I can say that I am at peace within myself and I am in harmony with others, then yes, I can say that I am either successful or I am on the path to success. Now, I need not repeat again what you must have heard 100 times, that in life there is no destination. It is how you enjoy the journey which is important. So when you say success, if it is one simple step of saying, okay, pass, fail, success is passing. The moment you have passed, where do you land yourself? What do you do with yourself? What does success mean to a student who is probably appearing for his first board exam in his life? Anything and everything revolves around success and the type of grades or marks that he is going to get in that exam that he is going to give. You ask him, what would you like to have in life? He would say, I have nothing else to aspire for. I don't care if I get anything else or not, provided I get this type of grades or the marks that I am looking for. And when he gets it, he thinks he has achieved something great. For how long? 24 hours, 48 hours, 48 days. And then what happens? Priorities change. And now he's chasing something else, success. Can I get admission in a good institution? Can I pass that second level of exams? Can I get a job? Can I do this? Can I do that? And then that's an endless stream. But if he learns to enjoy whatever he is doing, then he doesn't have to wonder what he is doing elsewhere. There was a story of a little guy who could never speak. He used to stutter very badly. And his school was having a theater performance, a drama. And this guy told his parents, I want to have a part in that drama. I want to have something important. And the parents felt very bad. They said, this guy is definitely not going to be given a part because he can't speak for nuts. Anyway, they said, go try. He comes back very happy and he says, yes, daddy, mummy, teacher said, I'm going to give you a very important role. Parents were shocked. They said, this boy cannot speak at all. And how come the teacher gave him a very important role? They said, what role have they given you? Said, teacher said, you have to sit in the first row and you have to go on clapping when our drama comes up, so that everybody feels that it's something great. It's one of the most important roles that you have to play, and I'm giving it to you. That boy was successful, according to himself. He felt that I got something. Whereas, there are people who would probably get the best role or the second best role, and they would say that I'm not happy with what I'm getting. In fact, I learn a lot of psychology from truck drivers who paint slogans behind their trucks when I'm out on the highways. There was this gentleman who had written in Hindi at the back of his truck, Insan ko apne dukh se utna dukh nahi hota, Insan ko apne dukh se utna dukh nahi hota, jitna dusre ke sukh se hota hai. No man feels miserable for his own miseries or misfortunes as much as if he sees somebody else happy. Now that is the greatest illusion. If I want to live my life comparing myself to someone, anyone for that matter, yes, success will always be an illusion, because there will always be somebody who is either better than me or who I perceive is better than me. I will never be able to be satisfied and say that, yes, I am successful. I have achieved something that I want to. People aim very high. The other day somebody was telling me that it is a crime to think small. Think big. Now, I don't know under what section of the Criminal Procedure Act it is a crime. But I didn't open my mouth to him because I think very, very small. This morning I was in another seminar, and as I finished that and I was coming with my friend Anish, and he asked me, you know, what's your vision and what are you looking for next? And I said, I'm desperately looking for lunch. That's what I was looking for. At that moment, lunch meant much more to me than probably a Nobel Prize. And I got it. One of my colleagues was celebrating something and she had ordered a wonderful biryani and kept it ready. And the moment I stepped into my office, I got this lunch and I felt that I'm a very successful guy. So I actually believe that it is these small things in life which give you that feeling of success, which big things just cannot give you. You may aspire, you may want to go higher and higher, you may want to get something very, very big. But there will always be this element of something missing somewhere. You aspire for success in small things that you want to do there and then. It is so much more easier to get success. Yet at the same time, since there is so much of debate about, long-term goals, short-term goals, how do you achieve it and all that, let me tell you that a teacher of mine taught me a very beautiful lesson. He said, asked all my classmates one day, we were in 9th standard, and he asked them all one day, he said, what is the highest success that you want to achieve in life? What is the greatest thing, achievement that you want to have in life? 9th standard boys, what would they say? Most of them had nothing much to say. One by one it was going on. When my turn came, impulsively I got up and said, sir, I want to be the president of India, sir. Ah. The same day as you are laughing at me, my classmates started laughing. My teacher, God bless his soul, came and said, get up. I said, I've had it now. So, he put his arm around me, turned to my classmates and said, what are you guys laughing at? What is there to laugh at? Don't you know that we live in a free democratic country where any person can aspire to become, any citizen can aspire to become the president? So why not Ali one day? What's so great about it? Why are you laughing at him? Then he turned around to me and said, son, you have great aspirations. You want to be right there at the top, right? But please back it up with very practical short-term goals, reachable, measurable short-term goals. And every one of your short-term goals should take you one step towards your long-term goal. And that's what I did. In fact, he trained me. I was a member of the scouts troop and he was the scout master. He trained me so well that I actually became what was known in those days as a president's scout. A president's scout in those days used to get a badge and certificate personally signed by the President of India and handed over in Rashtrapati Bhavan. And I got it at 15 years of age. And I felt that I'm a great successful guy, right? At that age, it was success. Thanks. At the same time, it gave me the impetus to think. At this age, I could do this. So why not one day I can be the President of India? Now, ladies and gentlemen, as I stand before you, I have still not become President of India. I thought there are much more senior people. Let me give them a chance. Let's not be in a hurry. But the point is that the way I enjoy life, the way I do whatever I feel like doing, I want to be good at something. I want to be the numero uno in something. I want to be an achiever in something. It may be very small from the world standards. But when I do it and I feel that happiness and that fulfillment, I tell myself, yes, I'm one step closer to becoming the President of India. And at the end of your life, when you turn around and look back, it's not the destination that you have reached, the final destination, the final success that is assured to all of us is death. And nobody wants that. Would you like to successfully die? You can ask somebody, no, I don't want to die successfully. Other than that, nothing is guaranteed in this world. So why is it that we chase and make it into an illusion when actually speaking, there is so much to enjoy in the journey itself? And it is regardless of your age, regardless of your status, regardless of your financial abilities, anything of that sort. There was that famous story which was told about some big shot who was attending a conference on a beachside resort, and lunchtime he comes out and he sees on the beach a young educated boy, apparently from a good family, etc., on a weekday, daytime, relaxing on the beach. And this man said, what is this young man doing? You know, such a lazy fellow, you should have been doing something. And he goes up to him and says, what are you doing? He said, I'm relaxing. You can't relax like that, you must work hard. He said, okay, if you say so, but why should I work hard? He said, if you work hard, you'll earn money, you'll get a position, you'll get this, you'll get that. Then what? And he said, then you'll get promotions, then you'll be able to buy a car, then you'll have a house, then you'll do this, and you'll do that. Then what? Then what? He kept on asking. He said, you'll be able to achieve so much in your life that you'll be able to retire very respectably and then relax. He said, that's what I'm doing right now. Now ask yourself, somebody would label that young man as an utter failure. Why? Because he's 20 years old and he's not working. If he was 70 years old and if he was not working, he would say, yes, 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 he deserves to have that. Who is there to decide on those numbers? Why should we be slaves to all those things? Who decides that an engineer is more successful than a lawyer, or a lawyer is more successful than an architect? Who decides what status, what position you get? As a counselor, as a person who deals day in and day out with human behavior and, you know, human relationships, I see so many very, very sad people. I see people who are right up there. 2 days back, we had the International Suicide Prevention Day. There have been so many people who are apparently very, very successful, great achievers, who have in the end committed suicide. Who didn't even want to live. They felt life is so bad after all those great achievements. Contrast that to what happened day before yesterday. The program got held up because of a generator fault. And there was this huge crowd of people at Freedom Park. We were all waiting for the generator to get going. One young boy came and he looked at me and said in Hindi, "Sab yahan chai milega." I said, do I look like a chai wala, tea boy or something? I said, no, I don't think there's any tea around. I saw him asking 3-4 people and then he disappeared. Exactly 10 minutes later, he was back with canisters of tea and selling tea to everyone. And everybody was just pouncing on him for that tea. Now here is a man who I felt knows what is success. He can create his own success. He looked like a very ordinary person. If you look at him, he must be an uneducated young man. But I, in my heart of hearts, says, this man is going to be a successful man in the true labeling of the word successful, because he is going to enjoy what he does. One last example I'd like to give you of how a successful person is created. A class of primary children, small kids, a teacher who's not very good at her work, somehow struggling on. One boy, very interested in studies. Amazing, no? One day before the class, he used to read up the lesson and go in the, So what used to happen was, whenever the teacher saying something, he used to correct her. No, miss, that's not right, miss, this. And she used to feel very miserable. One day she said, I have to teach this guy a lesson. So what she did was, it was the English language class. She said, today, children, we are going to have spellings. Who's good in spellings? First hand went up. Miss, I'm good in spelling this. I knew it. Yeah, fellow kept jumping up and down. Come here. Called him on the stage, gave him a chalk and said, go to the blackboard. You're good in spellings? Yes, miss, I'm good in spelling this. Go to the blackboard and write down, how do you spell crocodile? Such a big word. Tiny little fellow, he had never heard the word in his life. Go and write down, how do you spell crocodile? What is croco? See? Stupid fellow, you don't know, no? And you're saying, I know spellings, jumping up and down like this. That's why I tell you, don't show off. 1 minute, miss, don't scold me, I'll do it. He goes to the board and writes down, K-R-O-K-Y-D-L. Miss, crocodile, miss. Stupid dunce. I told you not to show off like this. You made a fool of yourself in front of everybody. Is this how you spell crocodile? Miss, don't scold me, miss. 1 minute. What did you ask me, miss? You said, go to the board and write down, how do you spell crocodile? Miss, this is how I spell crocodile, miss. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I do not know if this boy will ever learn how to spell crocodile. And it doesn't matter, because Google auntie is there to tell him how to spell crocodile. But I know he's going to be a successful person in the definition that I believe in, and I would like all of you to believe in, that success is not an illusion. Success is very real. Thank you very much.